Anita.
Well, I'm fed up to the back teeth with cretins like you. I never committed those robberies, so you get your facts right before you start talking crap about something that doesn't even concern you. Yeah, that goes for the rest of you bloody idiots.
Now, you listen to me, Maguire. We are not interested in your story. You save that for the judge, you understand? And if you want to keep out of trouble around here, you had better learn to control your temper. I'll start loading these in the washing machine.
Is everything all right here?
Oh, just early, Mrs. M.
All right, now, John's just been transferred to another cell block. She wishes to say goodbye. Mm,
good riddance.
It's Stevens they should be shanghaiing.
Yeah, bad luck, kid.
No, I think it's probably better this way. I've got to try and start getting my head together, and I think a change of scenery probably will help.
Well, that's great news. Best of luck to you, Belinda.
Yeah, thanks. You give him heaps of love.
Bye, dear.
Bye-bye.
Get your things.
Bye.
Stevens, have you seen the governor?
Yes, Mrs. Morris. Hope it works out for you, Belinda.
Hey, Ming, what do you reckon I could use?
For what?
Yeah. Well, something to put in your head that the screws can't wash out.
Why not leave well enough alone, Bobby?
Oh, because it's boring.
Hi, you want a cup?
Oh, I'd love one, thanks. Just wait. You and Meg will be holding the fort later on. I'm going to be out all afternoon and Joan has to go to that inquest.
Anything we need to know?
I did have a talk with Stevens.
She accused me of being out to get her, right?
Right, thanks.
I thought she might. Of course, you realise I couldn't have set her up in the library. I was with Hugh Bennett.
Yes, I know that. You're a good friend of her husband's, aren't you?
She didn't miss a trick, did she? Yeah, I know, Eddie. I don't see too much of him these days, though. He doesn't hang around with his old crowd anymore. Sonia sure made a mess out of him. I don't like her, but believing I'm out to get her, that's just paranoia.
Good. That's all I wanted to hear. Do you mind if I ask you why you left the police force? You don't have to tell me. It's off the record.
A lot of reasons, I suppose. You go into a job like that with ideals. It doesn't take too long for them to get knocked out of you. The things people get away with, both sides of the law.
Yeah.
It wasn't why I left. I mean, you accept that thing after a while just as part of life. Now, Colin, you asked, if I'm boring you,
I
just...
I would like to know.
Cut a long story short. The bank where my fiancée worked at was held up and she was killed. And I just couldn't understand how germs like that could get away with it with us so close behind them. Not until one of the plain clothes boys that was onto them became mysteriously wealthy. I had no proof. But that was enough for me. I just... didn't want the job anymore.
Rick, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, all cops aren't like that. Eddie Stevens, he's one of the good ones. He's dedicated, he's honest, and he winds up with Sonia. As they say, there ain't no justice. Well, I better get back to it.
Madam over there got the salts now.
Yeah, so would you if you was innocent.
If.
Huh. Come off it. Do you ever know anyone that said they were guilty?
Yeah. Oh, but I was. I knew that. Hey, you really reckon she is the cat?
Well, the cops seem to think so.
Well, hey, I've seen one of them movies once about them sort of burglaries, you know, people nicking over the rooftops, hanging on by their fingertips. Later I can remember what it was called, but Jean Kelly was in it.
It was Grace Kelly, to catch a thief.
That's the one.
You seem a bit quiet. You're working out how to deal with the problem, kid.
That one's got every right to be angry, Judy. I know who the cat is. And it isn't her. It's one of my kids.
Uh-huh.
Decided to play the big time. Doing very well for herself, too, as you probably know.
Yeah, $250,000 worth so far.
Of course, I'm very proud of her getting away with it. It's not doing our Maureen much good.
All right, ladies, come on, move out.
Hey, I'll show you around if you like, Maureen.
Thanks, but no, I'm causing Maureen. It's Mo.
Okay, Mo, whatever you say.
Hey, now we've got the pianola, Mrs. M. When do we get the guitars and the drums?
When they change the laws on noise pollution. Come on, move along.
Lucky Mr. Dobson ran water over your eyes. Diluted the bleach before you could do any real damage.
Yeah, well, they're still stinging like buggery.
Well, maybe. But if he hadn't come along when he did, you could have ended up totally blind.
Jeez, I don't reckon I could handle that too good. Thanks, Dan.
I just can't understand why you'd want to do a thing like that. It's silly. Your hair looks nice, the colour it is.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't expect you to understand.
Would she need to see a doctor?
No. She'll have sore eyes for a couple of days, but she'll be fine. I told you head back. I'll put in some drops. There. You just stay there till your vision clears.
You sure they'll be all right?
Yes, but I want you to come back at tea time for some more drops.
Yeah.
I have to get over to maternity. Do you think you could stay with her for a while, Mr. Dobson?
Yes, of course, sister.
Thanks.
Right, you know. I don't understand why the young ones want to do such strange things to their hair. Some of them look quite ridiculous.
Yeah, well, we reckon you old codgers manage that without even trying.
Sad to see someone your age in here. Where are your parents?
They never gave a stuff about me. Probably in a pub or a TAB somewhere.
Don't you have anyone? Nobody special at all.
Where have you been living? All that stuff's okay for books and movies, but this is the real world. I got me, and that's all.
Give yourself time, Mitchell. My daughter was exactly like you, till the right young man turned up. Now she's settled, got a family of her own, wouldn't change it for anything.
Yeah, well, there's no chance of that happening to me. Can't have any kids anyway, too many abortions. So what, even backyard abortions have to scrape out a living, don't they?
How are the eyes now?
X-ray vision.
All right, come along. I'll take you back to join the others.
So what are you going to do?
Oh, I don't know, dear. It's like heads you win, tails I lose. But I can't stand by and see young Mo stuck in here when I know she's innocent. I can't put young Sue into the copsy.